Okay, today we are going to move on to the or to continue with our circuit networks. And I will do a simple example which you did in A level, although most of you studied it. I would advise you to buy Nelcon 7th edition. Okay, especially those who want to be teachers, and you make sure you read it all when you are here. And when you go back, you are a superstar. You don't have to carry anything, you just put the book there and put the numbers. Because it's still relevant, especially if you can read the electronics part of it. It is simplified and more elaborate in Nelcon. And Nelcon has everything that some people say A level is not necessary, I mean, is not relevant. Our education system is, it encourages cramming. Who tells them that? Weather satellites, if you read the gravitation part of it, you read about surveillance satellites, what, those things I asked you in the exam and you still failed them. But people still have a mentality that things are not applicable. I don't know by which standards. Okay, so we parted when we had looked at the we divided our porridge into using the resistances R1 and R2. And if we were to look at these two points here, we would get this voltage here, V2, and we would have voltage V1. And that is if we add the V source in VS. This was a potential divider. And then we said we could also have these two resistances, and they are used for dividing the current. And when they are used to divide the currents into I1 for that going through R1, and I2 for that which is going through R2, whereby we have the original current I, which definitely flows back in here, of course, also here we have the same current I flowing all of them. Then we came up with the I1 being the same as R2 over R1 plus R2 I. I2 was equal to R1 over R1 plus R2 I, whereas V1 was equal to R1. R1 plus R2, yes, V2 was equal to R2 over R1 plus R2, yes. On that note, we shall work out by understanding the potential divider. So we do an example, and then we move on to the circuit laws. Hopefully by the end of today, the list will be out with the practicals. So I'll put it on the web as well, so that you can check around midnight or 1 AM and know the experiment you are supposed to do for tomorrow. The experiments tomorrow are after lunch, so if you know by tomorrow 9, you still be able to prepare for the practical. So you should be prepared in anyway. Have you gotten the manuals?
Yes.
The old ones?
Yes.
The two old ones, digital and normal, as well as the new one. I talked to the librarian, you gotta get both. The new ones for information in terms of the background and the differences, the old ones for what we shall use in the laboratory. And then I think I should also make you do the class. money. And I'm the man. Okay, so, hey, before I go on, Peter, you are Peter?
Yes.
And you smile. When I'm in serious issues and you smile, I feel offended. So now let me put the first that doesn't make you smile. So what happened? You know what?
That's the guy who did this work.
The what? Your window was hacked by who blocked
it?
So what solution did you opt to? Guys, I have rights to search for everyone's name in the system and know how many accounts you have on where. And I have those rights to see what image is associated, what photograph is in that person. When I'm adding people on the course, like those who told me that they are now on where, I didn't have to change the enrollment key. I put them on the course. And I still have two guys who have never gone to the course as of yet. Next time, before you to come, I have sealed the course, but no more entries. Oh, you had issues. I can see you bending to show your problems in gesture. So I can know. So when you create a new account, I know that you have created a new account. And you cannot take your own photograph my signature place near my office. So when I tell you go to Dicts, go to, are you science or you? When I say go to curriculum building, e-learning, look for Madame Rukia or whoever will be in charge to make sure they retrieve your email, there is nothing like blocking an email address. They got all the rights to get your password back. Even if you go to the Dicts here, they will be able to retrieve your password, even if you don't remember your username or what. Tell them the names, they will search, they will get you, they will get you all the details. But just because you grew up in a shrewd way, your parents are still in the electricity, they have another pipe for water, they make you tinker with receipts to account for the fuel and even make the first lady to go to Israel 9 times in a month because they want to account for the money. You also want to be that. That's why some of us who grew up in the village, you can't do any stealing in the village apart from the sweet potatoes, which is normal. You go on the sweet potatoes, you remove nicely, you put back. So that one is not stealing, it's selling yourself. But you here in the city, I mean, those of you who grew up somewhere, you still want to be shrewd when the right channels are there. And then you think you shall have a nice country. So we got our example of 10 volts. And then we have a whole big resistor here. And this resistance has a pointer or a slider. Another resistor there. So this resistance is as big as 2,000 ohms or 2 kilo ohms. This other left part here is 3,000 ohms or 3 kilo ohms. If this is 3,000, they are saying this one here is 1,000. If this is 0.8, and the slide, the pointer is at B, this is point C. They are saying that you find find the PD across BC when the slider B, so maybe I say the slider B is 1/4, is 1/4 up the resistor, or when 1/4 up, okay, 1/4, and then B, you say when the slider is 1/4 up and B halfway up. Halfway up the slider. This is our divider. It's like the way I showed you the those of you were there in the lab on Friday. It's like when I showed you the wheels where you slide. You slide the thing there and this way, so that's why we are talking about. I've been having that car. So, see, the questions sometimes are to make you realize and apply other skills that you have achieved. They are not giving you the amount of or the values of the resistance of the resistor. They are just giving you the values there. So, and the way they are arranged is a bit confusing. The gap is 3,000 on this side, you get 1,000 on that side. So that means before. And if it is a quarter, then it means you are 100, I mean 1,000. After the divider halfway, it would be 2,000. It's a simple one, just to make sure that you conceptualize the idea. So solution, we can try to make it a little bit more of what we are used to. So like, we got our 10 volts as our voltage, and then we got our, if it is 1/4, 1/4 means that 1/4 is, now we have two resistances in the series. So we have one resistance, which is, 3,000 ohms, and we have the other one which is 1,000 ohms, I think in this state as it is, and then we have the other resistor which is the load, normally which we take as the load, and this load is 2,000. So these are our points B and C. So the PD DBC will be equal to, first of all, you have to first look for the effective. This is our DBC. This is our VBC, and the PD across this place is affected by both of these resistances, meaning that you have to treat these ones as, because once it reaches here, before we tap it on this other side, it means that part of the current will divide itself here, another one there. And the PD across should be the sum, I mean, it should be due to the effective resistances. And I mean, I'm looking for a nice English word of, I can't say prison, I can't, maybe encapsulate, I don't know. The ones which are being, is a nice word that I can use, but I can't get the word. So this would be the same as, remember this is R1, this is R2, and then we will be having this giving V1 and V2, but now we are looking at this as VBC. So VBC is equal to R2, which R2 is RBC over RAB plus R. BC then multiplied by the VAC, where VAC is the total, which is the 10 volts. RBC is equal to a special case of two resistances in parallel, so which is equivalent to the product of the sum. This would be the same as 1,000 times 2,000. I guess the value is 2,000, yes. And then over 1,000 plus 2. Please, when you are writing your answers, try to be nice. Try to write well. I appreciate that you want me to run for the money they pay me, but remember also my mood determines your passage. You can imagine if I left here at 9 p.m. and I've reached home and I say I'm going to call these guys who are, and I'm dozing, and then when I look, you are writing like chicken. Some of you say we are scientists. Who told you scientists have to be fake? Otherwise, how would you know that? The doctors do it intentionally. They write like chicken just to make sure you do not buy the medicine anywhere. It's not that they know how to write badly. They write nicely, but they scribble it so that it is read by the scribbler, the fellow scribbler. So don't say they do that. So this would be the same as 2 times 10 to the power 6. Divided by 3 times 10 to the power 3, the 3's go. This will be 2 over 3 times 10 to the power 3 ohms. Then I can now substitute it for the RBC here. So I will get help from some of you who have calcs. I forgot mine. This would be the same as 2 over 3 times 10 to the power 3 divided by 2 over 3 times 10 to the power 3 plus 3 times 10 to the power 3 multiplied by 10. If possible, if you remember the example we did of R is equal to rho L over A, and we had to transform this one into pi d squared over 4, we did not use the pi r squared because we were not given the radius. So it is too bad for you to start changing the radius in diameter and then start using the formula for the pi r squared, because in those old struggles you are likely to make a mistake. So it's nice if you develop a formula whereby when you get 4 rho n over pi d squared, you are substituting exactly the value you gave. You can only run sort of accuracy if you either change the millimeters, And in the struggle to make the mirrors, maybe you very mistake can say minus 4. Then we understand it. But the value down would be the same. I would cancel it, yes, but at least where the value was the same with the wrong line. So those of you who have colors, what do we get? That is 9, 11 over 3, and that is 3 over 11, that is 2 over 11, times 10 to the power, 2 over 11, and then you have that being about 2 over 11. What is the value?
50 over 10.
You are telling me 20 over 11? Tell me the answer. 1.8 volts. We can take to one decimal place for this. So this is how you will find what trying to give you these examples to make you just calculate numbers. To show you how from this whole potential divider, how you visualize it in a more affordable circuit that you are used to by separate after your thing is this much value. So that was for one quarter. For one half is more or less the same, but here now we got our 1,000 becoming 2,000, and this one also becoming 2,000. And this is our B for halfway up the divider. And then we do the same stuff with only changing here to 2,000 and 2,000. And when that happens, this will be 4 million over 4,000. So this would be 4 here. And this would be 4 here. And this would be 1. And then here I would be adding 1 times 10 to the power of this. 1 times 10 to the power of this. This would be 2. This looks to be easy. This would be 3. A third is 0.3. So what do we get? A third is 10 over 3, which is 3.3 times 10. So 10 over 3, which is 3.3 volts. I guess now you can't have any issues to do with the potential divider. And you should do a lot of examples. You did a course in crystal magnetism. I want you to understand one thing. In A level, the schools decided, or the curriculum decided, to separate sections of physics, whereby you talk of optics, you talk of mechanics, you talk of electrostatics, you talk of electricity, magnetism. Guess what? These are all the same things. I mean, it is a continuity. It should be continuous. Because you find Newton rings in optics, you'll find the Newton laws in mechanics, you'll find the Newton-Raphson method in mathematics, you'll find Newton everywhere. You'll find even Newton relativity, something like that, in gravitation. Call it whatever you want. Meaning that these guys were all wrong. You find someone was doing medicine like Voltaire, as he was doing his surgery on the frog. That's how the volt came up. The volt in terms of the first barrel, liquid cell. And when he had slaughtered the frog, he saw the frog kicking. So when it kicked, he was curious. How can a frog kick when I had killed it a long time ago? Because when he was dissecting it, he had slaughtered, the neck was not there. Just like chicken, yeah, when you cut chicken, it runs. If you gave it a football pitch, it can run from here to the table before it dies. I don't know how sure, I mean, how true it is. So the traditional doctors use it as a way of conning people. So they say, they cut the chicken and say, it is going to look for who killed you. It runs around everyone, it starts running. If it is by accident, if you think you are strong enough and you retain it, it will come and step on you and they may lynch you. So take physics, and I'm very perturbed by how A-level teachers, including you who are going to be teachers, or you who are part-timing. I will discourage you from part-timing. If at all you can afford fees and one class of driving, don't go to a school. Because you fail your degree and the master will sack you and get another campus guy. Why do you think every time we produce teachers, why aren't they in these schools, which normally call you for part-time? Every year we produce teachers, physics, math. Why aren't they there? Why aren't they in Makere High? Why aren't they in Kasubu, whatever? Why aren't they in Kawembe Muslim? Why aren't they there? So when they give you 100 and you buy a smartphone, this Chinese one, and then your room has a carpet, and then you also have a TV or some woofer, you swear around. The degree is going down as your virtual lifestyle goes up, your degree is going down. So by the time you finish the course, you have been putting on a nice shirt, a nice shoe, and then you reach school, you fear even presenting your results. You come with your papers, but you are like, is there a place? you just want to just scare them that you have the papers. So, is there a place? Say, yeah, we have a place, but you have to bring your papers, the board will see it. Yeah, I'll bring them tomorrow. Then there is this young man who was hustling here. By the time I was here, I had my one shirt, T-shirt actually, my one trouser. I had some flats. I wouldn't care. I would be sitting at chemistry there, and then some boys would be going to dance. They have color TVs. And I wouldn't mind. I would go to my room and sleep. I say, we are going to Vogue, we even have complimentaries. They say, when you go and come back, tell me how life is. You share with me the joy. I also enjoy. And now I can buy anything I want. At least. Don't you think so? You continue part-timing. You continue showing off that you are part-timing. You will tell me when you are finished. But you won't fail to get a job. Math, physics, you'll get a job. But what kind of job? You'll still be a slave of this guy. You'll be begging him to retain you, but they won't retain you. I had a village mate who had a school somewhere, and I did a school practice center. He used to drive a car in the evening to come and check on me. I didn't know the reason. I thought he liked me so much. So when I was coming back, I said I needed to come on a Saturday, because me coming here meant Saturday. So he told me, no, you can go anytime, it is nearby. It was here in Kisasa. It is nearby. I told him, I have my principles. Reporting is on Saturday, and Monday I want to be in class. He told me, well, you can talk to the driver. The same truck he used to come and check on me almost every evening. He's now telling me to discuss with the driver. So I went to the driver and told him, I'm going back to Kampala, so he said 5,000. I told him, how much? 5,000. I said, okay. When I get it, I will call you. So I got 20,000 and gave it to, there was a neighbor with a pickup where I was staying. I put my small belongings on the pickup and came here on that Saturday evening. So when I finished the third year, this guy sent his brother to come and sweet talk to me to go and teach in his graduate Islam school. If you could come to check on me every evening, whether he thought I would be with some of his girls, I don't know. And when I want to go back, you can't give me a truck, then I'm not willing to come to your school. So I went to Mkono. Simply because I had the voice, had my paper. And when I went to Mukono, I told the guy, before I bring my luggage here, I want a house with 2 rooms. And I want to be on a school payroll. I'm not doing here school practice for free. He said, but I said, there is no but. I will go back to the village. I got the village and volunteer coming from home. I eat my soup for it, was at home. I go to the school and teach where I started from. I'll give them a service. He gave me the, he went and talked to the landlady and I was in my 2-roomed house. My years ago. So it's up to you. I'm saying all this to make sure that you understand. I will not come here and calculate the all this stuff here, and then you go and throw the books in the corner and then go to a school. And then when you are taking, you come here complaining. This course is hard, but do you put in effort? I read more than you do. For me to come here and cut these numbers for you, it means I have to prepare. What are you doing? That's why for me, I have no mercy. And when I fail you, because even if I say when you fail, you say he's the one who failed us. So let me say it the way you like it. When I fail, it means I'll fail you. Even if you go and dance on a needle. There's nothing you can change about it. I would have done it. So we now, I will not do anything to do with the current. The current divider, you have to go and read about it. So one was potential divider, two was the current divider. Now we look at the superposition principle. You did the superposition principle in electrostatics, whereby you had a single charge, and when you had a single charge, you introduced it within a given space. And when you introduced it within a given space, you did not do any work. It's like if I was to call somebody in a room here, or let's say if it was a dance hall, if you are the first guy to reach the dance hall, you look around and you are like, okay, where will I sit, where will I dance from? So you don't feel any pressure. When another guy comes and you had a tie, and for him he has a bow tie, you are like, maybe this guy knows how people here happen. So you start being stressed. So bringing a second charge, even the guy who comes and finds you there also feels a bit of pressure. And in electrostatics, you were able to see that the work done in bringing a second charge, the third charge, the fourth charge would be the total sum of the individual work done on these individual charges which were brought. And like electrostatics, here we do it in another way. So in a linear circuit, in a linear circuit with multiple sources, with multiple sources, the effect in a given branch, the effect in a given branch is equal to the algebraic form like some of the effects. Effects due to individual sources. Due to individual sources. Each acting alone. Each acting alone. Before I move on, there are two sources. Before I move on, you know this. There are two kinds of sources. In these sources, we have a voltage source and denoted by. You draw a circle, and then you put an arrow inside the circle, and then you put your. So if it is the voltage source is upwards, the arrow will be upwards. If it is downwards, then it will be downwards. Just like the way we draw a barrel. If this is our barrel. In the current going this way, the barrel will be like this. But you find another place where you have the when the current is going down. And of course, this is always if the loop is along the arrow, then it will be positive. The other source is a current source. Current source. And should we say denoted by or we say symbol? I'm being democratic. Symbol. So we say voltage source whose symbol is that. Current source whose symbol is. I should have lowered it a little bit down. So you draw the contacts and then you draw two circles. With an intersection like a Venn diagram. And then you can have your current eye coming out of the source. So when you, if you find such symbols in this course, don't be surprised where they are coming from. These are symbols which denote the sources in a given circuit. And of course, sometimes you find the person who drew the diagram is not all that, I can't say smart, but is not all that, when using a computer, sometimes you find that when someone drew this circle, if you put another circle without making it unfilled, then it will rub this one off. So you find in some of the text, because of consequences, something looking like this, where this part wouldn't show because the second circle covered the first circle. So don't be surprised when you find such a diagram. It means that this was supposed to be there, but it couldn't be shown. So I will not do a lot of examples on this principle because it is all about how to represent a voltage source by an equivalent circuit, how to represent a current source with an equivalent circuit, how to convert, if you have a voltage source, how do you convert it into a current source, and then we also be able to use this principle to calculate the current in any branch of a network and also use it to calculate the voltage across any branch of a network given circuits. So voltage and current sources or generators, because we can have a generator which just gives us current. We can have a generator which, when I say generator, it's like when we were looking at the DC supply, you saw the two slots, one for current, another one for voltage. But the whole network, the whole voltage DC supply, inside here are a bunch of resistors, capacitors, and diodes. All those stuffs are inside here. Inductors to make sure it is stabilized, because you are trying to rectify AC and change it into DC using the bridge. With all this inside this network, and you are having your currents going out, and this is your network of all these given here source, you can change this one into whatever you want, whereby you can have that scale which was showing amperes, or you can have where to tap and you get what you want as the voltage. So you have your voltage coming out of that. And these two principles we shall be using, the other two network theorems, Thevenin's and Norton's theorems. I don't want to go into them now until when we have enough time. That will be on. When do we have enough time?
Tuesday.
So I've already said that in the linear circuit, with multiple sources, the current and the given branch, or sometimes we can say that voltage across it is equal to the direct sum of the currents in a branch, or if we are talking of voltages, and we can take a no value or no figure example, so that we understand how we can play around with the principle of superposition. There are a lot of examples in a lot of books, and also you can use the circuits networks you know about and use them to test a given theory. There are circuits which you know you've worked out before using the elementary methods, then you now apply the superposition principle. Example. If we have our figure with these voltage sources, the resistor R1, R2, and then you have another voltage source here, then you have your resistor R3. So this is voltage source 1, voltage source 2. If you have this as current I3, because this should be I2, this will be your I1. We can try to look at each of these as two independent circuits, whereby if you pretend this one is not there, then you find out the effect of this voltage source too. And then you also pretend this one is not there, and then you find out the effect of voltage source 1. At the end of the day, the sum effect of these two voltage sources will be the sum of these individual effects when we assumed the other one was not there. So we shall start by eliminating voltage source 1. Or should we start with voltage source 2? So we first eliminate voltage source 2. If we first eliminate or negate porridge, sauce two, that is BS two. Then the diagram would be, we have our BS one, and then we have our R one, we have our, so R two, if we remove this one here, R2, we can extend it and it comes here because we have short circuit. That is by short circuiting VS. That's what it means by eliminating it. You put a wire across it, so you bypass it. That means you have short circuit. If you are trying to do something and you get the two wires together, or you tap the wire from the, don't do it this at all. You get a wire and you get a wire from here to here, it means that you have short-circuited this voltage supply. Don't try this at home, because you will not like what will happen. But that is what it means by short-circuiting, because you would have now, by you would have assumed there is no voltage source here, you have a continuous wire going across. Don't try this at home, because I will see you in heaven or hell if we happen to reach there. So you have R1 and then you have R3 here, and you have R2 here, and this is our new circuit, and then we can do the business. If we were to look for the currents I3 and I2, and this was I1, you now have successfully created the current divider here, and then you can use our issues of how to get I1 and I2, I3 and I2 by using the current divider. Next, we would get to eliminate VS1. So if we eliminate VS1, it yields the circuit below. So we would have now R1 being in parallel with R3. R1 R3. Then we will have our R2 here, and then we will have our V, VS2. And then we can also find out the currents which are flowing in here. And then once we have gotten all those two, then we can find the effective of the whole circuit, because we can easily now find the product of this after getting the product of a sum of this for parallel. Now this, the, these two, the sum here or the effective here and this one will now be in series. We get the effective resistance, we find the current which is being provided by this. After getting that current, we current divide it here, okay? Once we current divide it here by having the current through here is R3 over R1 plus R3. The current through here is times the I here, which the current which was given by the whole circuit. And then the current through here is R1 over R1 plus R3 times the current that is being provided by this source. So you have the current seen here and the current which will be produced here. Whereas when we want the current here, the current through R2 is R3 over R2 plus R3 times the current that will be provided, which is R1. And then the current I3 will be the same as R2 over R2 plus R3 times the R1. And then you get your currents through these resistances. And then you compare the two, you'll be able to find out that actually you get the value at the end of the day. Otherwise, you could use your Kirchhoff's laws and apply it within these closed groups, use these voltage sources, and also use the Kirchhoff's current law on the branches and see whether you get the same currents.
Currents or voltages? Because we are looking at voltage sources. So even the current street you will be getting, I think, will be a bit different. If you think about this in terms of just current, try to think about it in terms of the voltages.
And how do you get a potential difference without a current? If I have a current and I have the resistance, can I get a voltage?
Yes.
So where is the issue? I have already the voltage sources. I assume this is either 10 volts or 20 volts or 100 volts. I got the resistances, but I can use the current divider here, which we looked at previously, and once I use the principle of the current divider here, I'll be able to know the currents that are moving through R1 and R3. Similarly, I can get the currents which are moving through R2 and R3. I assume that this current shouldn't be different from this current here. But then I'll be able to get to R1 and R2. On that note, I will say that I feed it here. And, Tuesday, we shall come when you are ready to eat a lot. Come when we are ready for us to cover a lot of evidence and knowledge, and hopefully start on the... I want to give you AC, those phase diagrams and the like as an assignment, so that you revise your AC circuits. So that I can start from semi-conductors. Okay. A lot depends on how it goes. I guess your lecture is still here. Also, we do have the second years. Your lecture is still around here. Yeah.